welcome back to my channel. So today I'm back with a new video, and of course it is going to be an interesting one. Today I'm not going to show a regular makeup tutorial or like SFX makeup tutorial. Today I'm going to talk about hair. Now before I get started with my video, I need to give you some kind of like backstory. Actually, a couple of days before Diwali, I went to my hairstylist and to get a nice hair, not a nice haircut, just a, like haircut touch-up done. You get it what I mean to say. And I did a story about it on my Instagram, and a lot of you guys have started asking me, oh my god, Priyanka, you are again going for a haircut, how short you want to go? So that actually triggered me to do this kind of video. Then I actually conducted a poll on my Instagram stories that would you guys like to watch me doing a pros and cons of having short hair kind of video, and so many of you guys actually voted yes. So here I am. So without further ado, let's get right in. First, I'm going to talk about the cons because I'm a negative person. No, I'm not. I'm actually saving the good part for the last. I mean, that makes sense, right? I have written everything down so that I don't miss anything. Con number one, keeping a short hair is going to be expensive. Now, don't get any kind of wrong ideas, but let me explain it to you guys. If you're going to keep a short hair and you want to kind of maintain that style, you need to visit your hairstylist frequently. That means you need to go to your hairstylist like once in 2 months, and that is going to charge you around at least 1400 to 2000 bucks. Now that can be a really expensive. The reason is that if you have long hair, when it is like kind of growing out, you never really care about it because you can always throw it into some beautiful ponytail or beautiful bun. But when you have a super short, edgy pixie hairstyle, you need to maintain that. Otherwise, your hair is going to grow in an awkward shape and nobody wants that, right? Con number two, you have to put on some makeup when you have short hair. Now, don't get me wrong, guys, if you are not very comfortable wearing makeup but you still kind of rocking your short hairstyle, that is great for you. But when it comes to me, I feel that if I don't put any makeup while I'm going out and just I have super short pixie hair or maybe a short bob, I actually end up looking like a dude. So even if I'm going to take my groceries, I need to spend good amount of time like perfecting my wing eyeliner, you know what I mean. So yeah, that can be a bummer for you if you're a super lazy girl. Con number three, you have to choose your clothes carefully. What I mean to say is, if you have a pixie haircut, a really short bob haircut, you need to stay away from those clothes which has collars, like maybe Chinese collar, and maybe your shirts which has a proper collar, or maybe your t-shirts, because again, those kind of clothes are actually going to end up looking too harsh and too manly maybe. Now again, if you're super comfortable with that kind of appearance, is totally up to you. Nobody is going to judge you. But for me, when I had like super short pixie hair, I used to stay away from those kind of clothes. I used to look like a guy, which I didn't really like. So yeah. Con number four, people are going to judge you. Yes, if you are a girl in India and you are going to cut your hair super short, people are going to judge you or stare at you. Even when I went like for my pixie haircut, people used to come up to me and ask me, are you going through a breakup, or like are you a feminist, or you know, like all those kind of weird stuff. When I used to travel via train or bus or any local commute, especially aunties gives me a very dirty kind of stare. Now again, if you're a girl, and especially in India, you can totally discriminate like what kind of stare you are getting, which is creepy, which one is good, which one is appreciative. But mostly I get those judgmental kind of stare. If you're someone like aged lady who is currently watching this video, I respect you, I love you, but do not stare at someone and in a judgmental way. That is not very good, and it is actually very rude. And if you're considering to cut your hair super short, so get ready to get those kind of attentions. corn number 5. Now, it's not really a proper corn, you can say, but I just wanted to get it out there that if you're someone who really likes to experiment with your looks like me, once you have short hair, after a period of time, you will start getting bored and you might wanna like grow it back or maybe a long bob or like maybe a long hair, and that transition is going to be freaking painful, guys, because your hair is going to get in all those awkward shapes which you really don't want to deal with, and the whole process is going to be really tiresome and you need to have a lot of patience to go through that. But again, if you want to like just keep it forever your short hair, then it's not really a problem for you. But for me right now, I am trying to grow out my hair a little bit longer, maybe like this. So I am going through those awkward kind of phases. And that's what it, guys. Like that was the only cons that I have faced. But to be very honest, those are not cons for me because I thoroughly enjoyed my short hair journey. And now I'm going to talk about the pros. Pro number one. It is going to save you a whole lot amount of time while you are getting ready on a daily basis, because like you can literally see, you don't really need to comb it, you don't really need to braid it or tie it in a bun. You just wake up, do like this, and you're done. Pro number two. Now this one is my personal experience and this is a huge pro for me, that having short hair has improved my hair and scalp condition a lot more. Because if you think about it, guys, it will make sense to you, because when you have long hair, you need to style it, and in order to do that, you end up using lot of heating tools like blow dry it, you curl it, you flat iron it, and that way you are going to do a lot of damage to your hair. But when you have super short hair, you don't really need to do anything of that sort, and that's why your hair and your scalp is going to thank you. Before having short hair, I had like really oily scalp and oily hair. I had to wash it in every second day, which was a pain for me, and actually it triggered so many problems like dandruff and everything and hair fall. But I am sporting this short hairstyle for about a year now, and like this is all my virgin hair. This is really doesn't have any kind of chemical treatment, no color, nothing, and I am really happy the way it looks and the way it behaves. Now my hair and my scalp has turned into normal hair and scalp, so I'm freaking proud of that. Pro number three, you are going to save tons of money on shampoo and conditioner you used to spend when you had long hair, because like this point is pretty self-explanatory. If you have super long hair, the amount of shampoo and conditioner you are going to need is going to be much less when you have a super short hair like this, right? Tip number four, in India, which is a tropical country, and most of the time is summer is going to be the dominating weather here. Trust me, you are going to be in heaven on those summery days when you have short hair. Oh my God, guys, I cannot stress on that point, because me myself, I sweat a lot, and when I used to had long hair, it was like really disgusting kind of feeling that my neck area is always super sweaty and my hair used to stink. But when I had short hair, I'm like, summer, so I'm ready for it. Tip number five. Now this is something that it can overcome every single con, that you are going to look amazing when you have a super short hair, because having a super short hair is kind of liberating, guys. It's an awesome feeling. You are going to feel really comfortable and really confident in it, and I'm not kidding. And especially you are going to look fab in Indian clothes. I mean, just imagine you have a super edgy pixie cut and you are wearing a sari with really deep neck blouses. I mean, oh my God, that is something that I would like to look on my everyday routine. So yeah, people are going to compliment you, people are going to stare at you. Maybe it's a judgmental stare or maybe it's an appreciative kind of stare, but you are going to be the head turner and you are going to be pretty distinctive in a crowd, because in India still people are pretty doubtful when it comes to like cut their hair off. So for me, it was an amazing journey. I might go again super short, or I might grow my hair a little bit longer, I don't know, but I thoroughly enjoyed my short hair journey. That was it. Those are the like little pros and cons for me, but again, as I said, that I so much enjoyed my short hair journey that the cons are really not that that I'm not really bothered about those cons, you know what I mean. But still, if you're someone who have like really long hair and if you're considering to go for short or super short hair, I have some bonus tips and tricks for you guys. Yes, first of all, if you're considering to do it, then do your proper research before you go for it. And by saying that, what I mean is research for a good hairstylist. Please don't go to someone who doesn't really know what they're doing, because in India, hair is like a lot of emotion. So, and when you are going to cut it, it is going to be gone. I mean, when it is gone, it's gone. Until and unless you grow it back, you have to kind of deal with whatever you have. So just do your proper research and go to a proper stylist. I know that a good stylist can cost you like a couple of grand, and that is like really expensive. But please guys, I can assure that it is going to be worth it. So just go for a good stylist who really knows what they are doing. Bonus tip number two, again following up my previous point, which I have just said, that doing your research. Also do your research on what kind of haircut you want, because if you have like super long hair and you are just going to a good stylist and just sitting on that chair and just saying, you know what, I just want to go super short, don't do that, because you also in your head you might have like 10 different pictures and you are asking your hairstylist to give you a proper cut or whatever which is going to suit your face, but which might not you like. So having a clear communication with your hairstylist is going to help you a lot. Just go to Instagram, search with hashtag short hair or hashtag pixie cut, or go to Pinterest. You will get like tons of images, and from there you just kind of shortlist few looks that which you want to try, and go and talk to your stylist and just tell them what, that I need this kind of things. Now don't be super rude that your stylist might feel that you are doubting their skills, but just kind of have a consultation, I would say. It is going to make your stylist's job and your job also a lot easier and hassle-free. Now bonus tip number three, if you have super long hair and you are thinking to go for like super short, like a pixie straight away, I will say do not do that, because let's just think in this way, guys. You have grown up with really long hair, okay? Maybe 10-20 years of your life you have dealt with long hair. Now today, just one beautiful morning, you just woke up and you went for a pixie cut, which is super short. Now this is going to take some time to adjust your eye with yourself and your families and friends, everyone's viewpoint, kind of like they are very comfortable to see you in that kind of avatar, and it is going to take some time to get adjusted. Now if you're someone like who really doesn't care about all this and is really good about you, but if you're someone that who is still doubting and not sure but really want to get a short haircut, what I can suggest is you go like step by step. If you have like a waist length hair, how about you go and get a nice short angled bob. After that, gradually you take it shorter. That way you will also understand that if you are liking it or you are comfortable in it or not. And yeah, I think that is going to be a very safe thing to do if you are considering it. So that was it, guys. I hope I have been able to help you. And this video was like really important and kind of special to me, because this is the second hair related video I have done in my entire YouTube career, which is pretty short, but still. My first ever video was hair related, and I did how to style a short bob kind of thing. I don't really remember the exact title of it, but I do remember doing a really funny thing that it was my first ever video, but I said welcome back to my channel. I mean, that was literally my first video. How can I greet you guys by saying welcome back to my channel? So if you just want to have a good laugh, but that video was really informative too. I will just link it up here, so just click it and you will understand and few things about styling long bob. Okay, right now I'm just blabbering, so I'll just finish it right away. If you like this video, then don't forget to like, comment and subscribe to my channel. That will mean a lot to me. I will see you in my next video. Take care, bye.